It's my name, Abousfian Abdelrazik. As you know, I've been jailed in Sudan for 2 years. And maybe majority of you have knowledge about the Sudanese regime which does not respect human rights. In spite of this fact, CSIS, the one who's asked for my detention in that country. After my second term of detention, I came out and full of hope to come back to my children and to come back home. But I faced some difficulties during my struggle to come back home. One day I received a call from the Canadian Embassy in Khartoum. When I went there, the consular asked me to go with him in his office, asked me to sit down. And then he said, Abdelrazik, this morning, I have very bad news for you. Then he started to explain me about 1267 and Treasury border. Frankly, at that time, I don't have no background. I don't have no knowledge about what he spoken about. The only thing I understood from that conversation with the consular, when he mentioned to me, look, Abdelrazik, your name, it is appear on the list of belong to United Nations, and this is make it more difficult for you to go back to Canada, And it is make it more difficult for the Canadian government to help you out to go back. Really, at that moment, because I don't have knowledge, I don't have background about the 1267, I don't lost hope. I still in my mind to continue my struggle to come back. After 3 years, I realized I'm struggling for 3 years after that meeting to come back. I realized his word, including 14 months in the Canadian embassy. As you know, the conservative government doesn't help me to come out. I come out, as you know, because of the federal court order. When I came back to Canada, the difficulties is still continuous. Until this moment, I sit down in front of you. It is not over. And give you an example, and that the conservative government used the 1267 to prevent me to come back to Canada. I give you a tiny example. It is a personal matter. Last week, my son, the old 7 years old son, he asked me as a normal kid with daddy, daddy, can we go to Disneyland? I stuck, you know, I don't have no answer because 7 years old son, how can could understand the United Nations list? I'm really stuck, you know, it's a difficult situation for me to explain 7 years old boy. But I said to him openly, look, Qutayba, you want daddy to be in prison again and to be away from you for long time again? But he said, daddy, no, I don't want that. I don't want to go anywhere. You see, other example, when I came back like normal person in Canada, normal citizen, I have a bank account with Royal Bank before I left to Sudan. I want to reopen account, my account with Royal Bank. When I went there, the fact they refused, and they mentioned that my name on the list 1267, and even they give me a letter, say that in the letter, this is a letter here, of the refusal of the Royal Bank. I asked myself, why on that list, why? Because I don't have no explanation for myself. And even I don't have explanation for my children. Why on that list? Why our life is to be difficult and not to be normal like everybody else in Canada? When I came back to Canada, I asked two ministers from the Harbour government, the Minister of Foreign Affairs and Public Safety, to sit down with them and to ask them to help me out to delist my name from that list. But the boss minister, they refused completely. And more than that, they asked me to go to United Nations website and to do that by myself. And for the individual, it is extremely difficult to do it. Thank you very much.